go.
Whoa!
Whoa!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Well, welcome here at all, and the people who left early, fuck them.
Well said.
The question is, am I warmed up from doing those other two albums, or am I tired out?
Warmed up.
Warmed up.
There's the answer.
How many people have just joined us now? Yeah, that? One, two. So you're all here before.
Yeah.
I don't tell the same old anecdotes. Same old things. I have to come up with new stuff.
All right.
The year, ladies and gentlemen, was 1983. Weird year. It was a very weird year. And the Church have made its third album called Seance.
Yay!
And it came out and went straight into the charts at number 13. And then I went on a holiday to Europe. And after about a month, I was troubled and I rang up Marty Wilson Piper and said, I had a dream. That album went in the charts at 13 and then it fell back out the next week, and he said, it did. That's what happened. Went in at 13, it's like an upper number. So that was it. That was Seance for you. Went down like a lead balloon. And it had, there's a bit of controversy surrounding the mix, a guy mixed it. Oh, you've all heard of that before. This guy Nick Launay did his thing, and it was at sort of odds with what the record was supposed to be, and it was all a bit of a mishmash. But looking back now, it's sort of a lot of people in America say, oh, Seance is my favorite record by the Church. It's sort of a weird, it's a weird record. All right, therefore, without further ado, adieu is what I say at the end. Adieu, ladies and gentlemen. So without further ado, because I don't want to talk my time away, like almost happened in the last one. Lucky there's a clock up here, I can see where I'm up to. I've already wasted almost 10 minutes, can you believe that, without playing a single fucking note, or saying anything we didn't know. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to give you a seance.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Smile like a tiny child. She talks ahead of family that lies wide. Toss and turn on teardrops sleep. All those dark clouds who look here for me and the fright. She pointed up into the sky. And you can't touch them if you try. And they fly. Hater left when she lost her breath. Hater sends off to some unknown day. Trapped inside a painted eye. Takes herself into the new sunrise and the fly. She pointed up into the sky. And you can't touch them if you try. Yeah, they fly. Thank you. tell me, is everything unplanned? It's all so unexpected, I just don't understand. You run so hard and always end up in the same place. Now that went so smoothly, well, that never is the case. One day, down the cloud is bright, it will shake away the shadows of eternal night. It's just a storm before the calm, like the life held in your palm is clay. One day, and you stand there, the lashes blowing past, dipping into guilt and love that will be made lost. And the gold you spend and the hissing and that you throw into the sea, coming back 100-fold, maybe there's no guarantee. One day, doubtless clouds rise, will shake away the shadow of an eternal night. Just a tune before the call, like the life held in your palm is clay. One day. About seance. I suggested we were going to have a tour, and I suggested we should call it The Church Contact the Living. And I was being really facetious, checking, that's a good idea. And there was The Church Contact the Living, which was a frivolous suggestion. All right, let's get on with this one. Thank you. as the city calls, electric people, nobody knows. Electric dream, nobody shows. You touch my skin, feeling is electric.
Chance at the end, okay? That, I like that. I like the way some people were slightly out of time. You gave it a humanity and an authenticity that I'm searching for. I hoped that our destiny's slow. Errors. Now it comes away. Of children, I see the future just sliding away and falls down as the city glows. Electric people, nobody knows. Electric dream, nobody shows. You touch my skin, feeling is electric, electric, very electric. You can add very if you like. Electric, very
electric.
That's nice. It's so electric. Last time round.
Electric.
Very electric. Very electric. That's my first time I've ever done that. That's the first time I've ever got anybody to sing electric in that song. It's like the possibilities. Implications are stunning.
All right.
We made this video of Richard Lowenstein. It was this post-apocalyptic. There's a lot of post-apocalyptic stuff going on there. It was a very Melbourne video. And we, what's that sound? It sounds like an elephant outside the door. We went to this place in South Melbourne that was like an old warehouse, and we could sort of walk around lighting fires and smashing windows and stuff. And we were sort of like, it was a post-apocalyptic world. But I was still sitting around a fire, huddled there, singing my fucking song. Even though it's post-apocalyptic. It's very hard to keep saying it. Post-apocalyptic. Mental note, work on saying post-apocalyptic. It's not a good word to fuck up. So we did this song. This song's called It's No Reason. Do you remember that one?
Yeah.
Did it race to the top of the charts?
Sure.
Should've.
Did it race to the middle of the charts? Did it get played on 3XY once at 4 in the morning? Crocodile skin water, city shadows wave. Put your hands into my head, yelling is so brave. Buy a ride to sundown, buy a ticket home. Take all the things I
to stir. Red or pink, some will sing. Have you even heard? And the colors take me down. It's no reason to be sad. How did you allow herself? It's no reason to be glad.
It's there somewhere.
Salty tears are wasted, children lie away. Put your head into my hand, let your spirit rain. Like smoke from the chimneys, like smoke from the hills. Everything is moving, but we're standing still. There's no reason to be sad. Imagine me without a sound. There's no reason to be glad. Celebration fading, bolts upon the waves. Put your head into my hand, try to be brave. Mountains of sun, storms left us peace. Poppies sleep undamaged, try to believe. And the colors take me down. Give me a reason to be glad. And you hear that sound. It's no reason to be glad. This next song, it said, was a stoned out jam that should have never made it into the studio, let alone made it back out again. You gotta love that. All right. I lose my bearings, but I can see clearly. trout by floor, trout by floor, trout by floor.
Where do you want to go? Anywhere that you know. Trout by floor, 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 trout by floor. What do they mean, stoned out Jack? Where do they fucking get that from? Isn't it funny? Jamming's bad, but writing's good. What are you doing with jamming? Oh, no, we're writing. Oh, well, how did you think we wrote about jamming? Of course, it's worth repeating this old chestnut, this anecdote, which is getting a telegram from the Queen next week if I say it again. We're working on these songs, and I didn't. The songs are starfish, and he said, "Kilby, where are the lyrics?" I said, "I haven't got them yet." He went, "What are you gonna do? Just make them up?" Yeah. Oh wow, we really. You know what? I know people who are interested in time will be impressed by this. This is, you know, there's a lot of things you can say about me. But it's now 9:30, dead on the knocker where I should be, at the end of side one.
Yeah.
I'm bringing this one in. I'm bringing this one in. We're right exactly where we should be. I don't want to get it wrong. I don't want to end 5 minutes too soon, 5 minutes too early. I'm gonna give, I don't want anybody saying, he spent 45 minutes on that one, and my friend Sharon had 15 minutes. I'm evening it up, all right? So we're now on the second side of seance, okay? And here's this song. It's a terrible one if you fuck it up. Somewhere must have talked some sense. I could feel it moving underground. So many things still don't understand. The dream I was having took on another face. I don't know if I was walking through heaven. It could have been any place. Skipping across the water, sad. Late to find you gone and open to my sleep. Well, it wasn't just a thing you told me, it was a thing you had to leave. No, I know I could never get that near me. What do you expect me to disappear? We're as free as we can be, can't you see? Like the trees so on the sea. Disturbs me, I throw it to the wind. And after all these hellos, goodbyes, etc., we can't stop this thing again. It's like a fog you walk towards and never seem to reach. Every morning now, I hear that same old song. And though the singer is long dead, his voice goes on and on and on and on. Ugliness you have to learn, beauty you can't see. Wait to find your love until
that's just where you lay. Well, I just had to laugh for things you'll never hear me say. Now I see you will never hear what it makes me do. As free as we can be, don't you see? That the tree is so obviously.
It was authentic, which permits a multitude of sins. Well, as I was saying before, I've had another cookie, I had another brownie. They're very unpredictable. When you mix them with alcohol and AstraZeneca, the results are very unpredictable. Ladies and gentlemen, you know I'm a poor, starving, miserable musician with absolutely nothing who lives in abject poverty in a two-bedroom flat in Coogee. The Memo Hall are only paying me $1 million to do this show. And if you don't buy some merch, I don't know what's going to happen. If you don't buy some merch, I mean, Christmas is only 358 days away. And you know what? What a statement if you have an enemy you really don't like, you buy him some of my arty-farty merchandise. He's like, what the fuck did you give me this stupid Ganesha pillowcase for? I barrack for Carlton, mate. What the fuck is this? So a great way, even if you don't like my pretentious merchandise, overpriced t-shirts fall apart, books, the letters, the words fall off the page, it's all untrue, the records, the CDs are scratched. What else? The pillowcases, they're all used, stolen. There you go, stolen from a hotel in India where I stayed once, and passing them off as my own. Ladies and gentlemen, just imagine the statement, the impact you can have with some Steve Kilbey merchandise purchased here. They're like a memory, a solidified of what a wonderful night you've had tonight. All the people who just joined us before for Seance and Heyday, thank you very much for coming out tonight. Unfortunately, a few people, and I can really understand it. Then they didn't decide to. After three times, we almost got there, and all the people who could have seen it could have seen, and it would have been great. But I really appreciate the people who did come tonight. I really did, and I respect that. Thank you. I tell you what, 2 years of playing Instagram gigs make you suddenly go, wow, the audience is a really good thing. The audience. I remember the audience, and it's really wonderful to actually play to an audience, especially in a lovely venue, a lovely, civilized audience. It's nice atmosphere in here, and I'm really enjoying myself. So,
thank you.
I drove down the post road, you know. Yeah, I couldn't fucking. The rules of getting on a flight, I was like, which way is the wind? Which test do you have to have? How many minutes before you get on the flight? It was just so I decided to drive down. I drove down on the coast road. Yeah, stopped in Cam River. And wow, as soon as you get into Victoria, everything's really nice. It's true. Now I'm going to Marlow. I'm going to get a residency in a pub in Marlow.
and play Creedence Clearwater. Looking for a job in the city, working on mail. I'm just gonna get a deck chair, and that's it. I'll become a Victorian at last. For sure. I tell you what, in an alternative universe, you can think of a lot of better ways to spend the rest of my miserable life. I'm sitting in a deck chair in Marlow playing Proud Mary. Meanwhile, ladies and gentlemen, sorry for that digression. All right, I'm charging no extra for digressions tonight. All the anecdotes, the banter, the repertoire, that's kind of dodgy. The repertoire. And oh, it was a very wooden performance. It was repertory. It all comes free of charge. It's all just to give you, put you in the picture. So you feel like it's like, in 1983, I want you walking down the street. It's 1983. And in 1983, Richard Plug and I were sort of in some stage of arrested development. And our favorite thing in life was static electricity. Wow, could you have some fun if you had these boots? We used to get these boots made by a guy in Richmond. He's not there anymore. And the whole band would go, I want that color and that color and that color and that color. Plug had fucking pink Beetle boots. I had green ones. The other guys had silver. Anyway, we had these boots, and something about the property of them, really, if you got on the right sort of nylon carpet on a very dry day, and you had a key, you could really, in the EMI studios, you could give someone a huge shock. A big blue spark would jump out the end of the key and hit them. And also, there were a pair of plastic trees. As you walk through the vestibule, on a day like that, if you'd worked up enough charge, you'd see the shocked faces of a boy who's there to deliver a veggie burger. And as he walks through, both plastic trees would bend over and give him a massive fucking blue shock in each ear. And Plug and I loved it. And so I wrote this song about it. This is a song. This is Stuart Coop, that famous journalist. He said that this was the most meaningless song he'd ever heard, and he was wrong. It's full of meaning. How could you cram more meaning in there? I'd get done by the Poetic Association for oversaturating the meaning. Electric Lash. The trees in the studio feels my head fly. Only the voice of a girl on the radio falling from a high. I turn to Lee, sipping a cameo, it doesn't feel quite right. Only one thing ever really known is day or night. Eyes me and I love her, but I suspect she already knows. How was I seeing you so very, very clearly? Even when they're closed. Electric lights, the trees in the studio by then a caress. Only the voice of a girl on the radio drifting from the west. I turn to leave, sipping a cameo, moon, not guess. Only one thing you ever really know in my curse. Before you bless our eyes, me and I love her. I suspect she already knows. How's I see me so very, very clearly, even when they're close.
electric lash. The trees in the studio feels my hair fly. Only the voice of a girl on the radio falling from the night. Yeah, I turn to leave, sipping a cameo, it doesn't feel quite right. Only one thing you ever really know if it's day or night. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Searching in my head for some meaningful anecdotes about seance, the life and the times. A strange thing happened just when seance came out. Dire Straits asked if we could open for them on their tour of Australia, which was very strange. And suddenly we're in these great big rooms, like entertainment centers where we'd never played before, playing to an audience who didn't really like us very much. And I remember sitting backstage and all we had was one half empty bottle of soda water. And I was like, fucking Dire Straits. Suddenly the door opened, Mark Knopfler was there with his headband on. And he said, "Hey, boys, how are you? You right for drinks?" And, "Yeah, Mark, yeah. Good, boys, good." And he walked off. And we didn't even say, "No, we don't have any drinks." We had our chance, and we never told him. That's interesting to know, isn't it? That's something you didn't imagine happening. The church sitting there in the... A guy said we had putrid paisley shirts buttoned up to the neck. See, I remember all the bad reviews. Richard Plug's drumming turned tempting mysteries into turgid mistakes. Turgid. All right, that's one thing, there aren't so many rock critics around anymore. There're not really many like there used to be. So guys you'd be really scared of, they gave you a bad review. They sort of don't exist. The ones who write only write nice things now. It's sort of gone out of demand of the critic with those really nasty ones that used to sort of make me cry. When I got a bad review in English press, I went down to the import record shop and bought my special NME the week it came out, only to find it had a bad review. No, inevitably, people in Australia would find that out 3 months later. Because there was a lag. All right, so we're halfway through the second side of Seance, ladies and gentlemen. I've got a little number for you called Now I Wonder Why. In a moment of triumph, I find defeat uncontrol. In a second of honor, a despair shall window. She gives me a taste to show me something to get. I wasn't looking for you, and I don't want to find you. In an uncut window, in a street full of blood, following the garden and pursuing the blues. The world is so wide, she never sees me anymore. But I trusted you then, and I'm trusting you still. It's just now I'm not so sure.
far, like an elder blues. But the game is hardly what I choose. Now I wonder why it was somebody, a woman, who was a delicate crime. And I've been waiting for ages, I've been here all the time. Was this greed in my blood? Let me take the easy way. Help me hide the vagabond that was myself yesterday. And during the dream, I found that I couldn't see. During my acting, I found that I was too deep. By the virtue of faith, I knew I could be lost. Beyond this dark place, I'm prepared to pay the cost. Now, I wonder why I thought I could ever lose. Though the game was hardly what I should. Now I wonder why. Was this green in my blood? She let me take the easy way. She helps me hide the vagabond. But I trusted you then. They showed me some etiquette. I knew I could be lost. I knew I could be lost. I knew I could be lost.
Thank you. Really?
Yeah,
wow, thank you so much. I've got one voice going, wow, you're doing really well, and the other one's going, man, man. All right. Well, okay, so we're coming to the second last song of Seance now. It's a little number called Dropping Names. To be beautiful, 7 long nights of things. A handful of words, a sleepful of birds, casually left on my sink. Crimson leaves, cut out your feet, leave the thinner more in the pink. 7 long days with a conscience my ways, look over my shoulder and say, hey, hey. All to the courses, stand in my flame. Questionable sources, only watching name, dropping name. Yeah. Well, alright. I taught her how to be hard or soft. She never really needed to learn. Shopping in town, defenses are down. I never, ever need to return. She held me by the stars, says look at these scars. Feel my longing burn. 7 long nights I'm praying outside. The hair on my shoulder made me feel alright. All water corset, stand in my flame. Questionable sources, only dropping names, dropping names, dropping names, I'm dropping names, yeah, I'm dropping names. Thank you. We're almost, we've got one track to go for sounds. Wow, I can't believe how I'm managing time here. I think that's the most, anybody said to me, what advice have you got for a young kid about to get in the music business? I said, be able to manage time. When you get on stage and you're hired for 45 minutes, don't play for 40, don't play for 50. 45 minutes. Know what 45 minutes feels like. Get in touch with time. That's be my advice, seriously. That's how I got here. I still can't play and sing, but I can apportionate four albums out into 2 hour sets with an hour break in the middle, deliver it all smack bang on the end, even play that other song, have 5 minutes for that other song that you're probably gonna want at the end of the other one that doesn't on any other albums, you probably still want to hear it. I've got to get that. You don't want to hear that? I see now you're sending me mixed messages. Okay, well, you've got a warning, so have a warning. At the end, that could possibly rear its head. Okay? All right. So, here we go. We've got the last track on Seance coming up. And then we'll be back into Heyday. You can do, you know what you can do? It doesn't change. Would you like to do that?
Yeah.
Only if, don't, not if you, you know, if you're beyond that, but if you would like to,
okay.
What? You want to do it? Okay, don't break my balls. Okay, you know? Yeah, it's not so easy. Okay, we're going to have people want to do it, people don't want to do it, don't do it, people do it nice, and it's like a whisper insinuating itself into your consciousness. Okay? It doesn't change. Okay, do you want to have a little? Okay, here we go. Sinking silk, burning gold, touch you as the air is turning cold. Doesn't change. Seeing things just rest a while as the tide sweeps out. I can't remember. It was so onto thinking where that happened. I can't remember the next words. Is it seeing things? No, that's the second. Say it. It's just coming around on the treadmill. It's on the treadmill. What's that? I'm going to go right back to the beginning, so you have a chance to sing. It doesn't change us. All right. No. We're going to enjoy this. We're going to do it properly. No, I signed a deal with Memo Hall. Don't not do the songs properly. Oh. Sinking silk, burning gold, touch you as the air is turning cold. Seeing things just rest a while as the tide sweeps out. Silent man, pleasure dawn. This is a world that I once loved.
Mr. Fear, shrug your shoulders and then disappear. Strangers in the naked skin, waiting for their sweet oblivion.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.